Hey guys, what's happening? Niyat here with Film Comics Explained, and with the highly anticipated upcoming release of the movie Terminator Dark Fate, I thought it would be great to continue our Terminator series by covering the TX Terminator, featured in Terminator 3 Rise of the Machines. I already have a few videos covering the T-800, the T-1000, and even a comprehensive video going over Skynet itself. So if you haven't seen any of those, I'll be leaving a link to them below, and I highly recommend that you check them out, as I'll be referencing aspects of the series I mentioned in those videos here. But with that having been said, the Cyber Research Systems Model TX, the Terminatrix, or the TX Terminator as it's more commonly known, was a highly advanced model of the Terminator, succeeding the T-800 and T-1000 models. Produced by Skynet in an alternate timeline created from the first attempted assassination of John Connor, the unit was dispatched by Skynet into the past to terminate John Connor, his lieutenants in the future wars, and other Terminators sent to protect him.
So, she's an anti-Terminator... Terminator? You've gotta be shitting me.
No, I am not shitting you.
With the massive success of the mimetic polyalloy T-1000 series, Skynet continued to develop its liquid metal technology, this time by combining it with the advanced endoskeleton of previous models, more specifically the T-900 series. As a result of this, the TX was much stronger, faster, more intelligent, and deadlier than any of Skynet's previous battle units, effectively rendering them redundant, also Skynet had thought. The TX was designed by Stan Winston and his studio, who'd worked on the previous two films directed by James Cameron. Originally, the TX's endoskeleton was meant to convey an androgynous shape which would permit the android to assume the superficial traits of both men and women, though later designs veered on it being more feminine. The final approved TX design was done by Aaron Sims, who designed it entirely on computer through a mixture of Photoshop and 3D software. In order to differentiate it from the silver sheen of the T-800's endoskeleton, the TX endoskeleton was painted chrome black and fitted with blue running lights rather than the original's red. It's also worthy of noting that the individual parts of the TX endoskeleton were hard-coded, sanded, and polished through machines, resulting in a mathematically perfect model, unlike the endoskeleton in the Terminator, which was sculpted by hand and lacked the same symmetry. In the year 2032, the TX was built and battle-tested by Skynet against several other Terminators, including the T-800, the T-900, and the T-1000, and it defeated them all in hand-to-hand combat and weapon-based attacks, effectively destroying each of them with its powerful plasma cannon. The TX series had an advanced utilitarian battle chassis, weighing in excess of 150 kilos. Protected by malleable, crystalline ceramic armor interlaced with nanofibers of carbon and titanium, the TX was practically unstoppable on the battlefield, capable of sustaining extreme amounts of damage with seemingly little to no effect on its operating systems. Extremely strong and agile, the TX series was capable of moving its joints in ways that would be impossible for any human or older models of Terminators featuring an endoskeleton to do. Aided by artificial liquid steel lubrication, each joint had a massive degree of rotation. The neck was capable of 360 degree rotation, and the torso was capable of at least 180 degrees of rotation, as seen in the film. The enhanced joints also showed little to no wear or degradation when moving at high speeds, allowing the TX series to run at speeds in excess of 80 km per hour for brief periods of time before its power packs began to show slight decline, requiring it to manually recharge before continuing its pursuit. Due to the integration of powerful hydraulics in conjunction with its carbon and titanium endoskeleton, the TX series was capable of easily crushing a human spinal column with just two fingers, and its thighs could crush with a pressure greater than an industrial hydraulic press. Its steel jaws and alloy teeth were harder than industrial diamonds, and could crush and cut through titanium, let alone human muscle and bone, though we don't get to see it do this in the film. Yeah. Like the earlier Series 1000, the Series TX utilizes mimetic polyalloy. However, whereas the Series 1000 was constructed entirely from this liquid metal, the TX series only had a liquid metal outer sheath covering its endoskeleton for infiltration purposes, which essentially gave the T-1000 a competitive advantage for being able to regenerate better. Stored within small reservoirs in the cranial casing of the TX when in endoskeletal form, the mimetic polyalloy not only aided in infiltration, but it also added strength to the overall armor of the TX series. Because it's only coated in this material, it was possible to remove it from the endoskeleton using an immensely strong magnetic force, such as that from a particle accelerator. Having a solid endoskeleton did solve some of the T-1000's problems, namely being deformed by temperature extremes and explosives, while also lacking built-in ranged weaponry. However, the endoskeleton made the TX less flexible than its T-1000 predecessor, in that the TX didn't have the ability to liquefy and assume forms in innovative and surprising ways, including fitting through narrow openings, morphing its arms into solid metal tools or bladed weapons, and walking through prison bars or flattening itself. Like the T-1000 before it, the TX could take the form of any human it touched, typically terminating the subject prior to assimilation. The TX was also able to use advanced psychology to mimic and trick targets that it saw, as witnessed in the film when it increased its bust size after being pulled over and seeing a nearby Victoria's Secrets billboard, using this as a distraction on the policeman that pulled her over, before taking him out and stealing his weapon. I always found this scene odd, as it didn't really need his gun, given the fact that it actually had over 25 weapons within its body that it could use to engage targets, though we only see it use a handful of these in the movie. Aside from its increased strength and armor, the TX series was also fitted with onboard weapon systems, and was the first infiltrator class to house advanced weaponry, each located within a reconfigurable arm, underneath the mimetic polyalloy outer sheath. Within its vast internal arsenal, the TX possesses many different weapons and tools for different missions, including but not limited to a chemtech flamethrower, EMP generator, .223 automatic stopper, a cluster gun, KLD magnum repeater, and a plasma cannon. Though it possesses many forms of inbuilt weapons, the primary weapon of the TX series was its plasma cannon, which was highly useful when it needed to take out other Terminators, with a well-placed shot being the only thing needed to bring them down. In addition to its increased combat proficiency, one of the main reasons it was a more effective Terminator was that it had unique nanotechnological transjectors. By retracting the mimetic polyalloy skin from its index finger of the right hand, a 1.6mm titanium alloy drill bit would emerge from the fingertip. This would then be used to drill into the casing of any electronic system, transferring a stream of nanobots into the system. With this ability, within a mere matter of milliseconds, the TX could connect with the electronic system and reprogram it, controlling it by direct link or ultra-high frequency contact via a downlink with military communication satellites under Skynet's control. In this way, a TX can take control of any machine, from simple electronic locks, automobiles, to other battle units. Though it should be noted that if it chooses to take over another battle unit, the TX can corrupt the other Terminator's systems, leaving its CPU intact, but it's unable to control its other functions, which is why the T-850 in the film was able to crash its own system and reset itself to regain full control of its operating system. One of the reasons that it was so efficient at assassinations was that, unlike its predecessors, the TX series was equipped with advanced sensor packages to aid in human identification and termination. These included infrared systems used to pick up heat signatures, facial recognition technology, and retina scanning systems, though the creme de la creme of its advanced sensor packages would have to be its capability of analyzing DNA by sampling a small quantity of its target's blood using sensors housed within its mouth. I also thought it was odd that the TX appeared to possess a limited emotional range, which it exhibits even when it was by itself, as opposed to displaying emotions to ingratiate itself with humans, which was a common trait of the other Terminators. This can be seen during the crane chase when it exhibited frustration, and also performed a surprise double take upon realizing the T-850 was still in pursuit. It also appeared to look satisfied when it smirks after seemingly losing the T-850, exhibited a fear response just before the T-850 finally terminated it with one of its hydrogen cores, and more notably, early in the film when it identified blood as belonging to its primary target, John Connor, the TX appeared to react with an expression akin to what I'll playfully describe as extreme elation. Thank you. Despite its superior technology compared to the T-850, the TX ultimately failed in its mission of taking out John Connor and Kate Brewster. Well, that's all for today, folks. A big thanks to all of you guys who requested we take a look at the TX Terminator, featured in Terminator 3 Rise of the Machines. Don't forget to hit subscribe and click the notification icon to stay up to date on all my content. And if there's anything else you'd like to request, please don't hesitate to ask. As always, it's been a pleasure. Niyat here with Film and Comics Explained. Thanks for stopping by.